So that was the boss that I fought there. As you see, when I use the silver ring, I get an extra attack on my character, and it actually makes the boss battle a lot easier. And so right now, to save a lot of time, I went back to the king and told him about my heroism. Well, it looks like despite all the things you've done for the king, he's still looking for the immortality. And we tell him the truth that we actually don't know what caused immortality. And it's probably worth noting that I should have mentioned this a couple parts ago, that the character Stein, or Stena, her in the party, she doesn't know about her past either. So we got three immortals who got amnesia. Now the good thing about it now is that I can actually grab the treasures here. So Wagnector, of course, heals all your HP, and we know Magic Carpet does. You're able to travel anywhere in the world that you want to. Magic Carpet, Fireball. Fireball is just you just use it as an item, and it acts like a fireball as a spell. It's no bigger, no biggie. And it has charges. So these, if you don't already, these are the girls the king is pretty much, well, you know. So it really doesn't matter which chick you think is the most beautiful. I'll give you love. Just a bit. So yeah, so you must say they're whoring around. No, it's not funny. King sleeps here. And apparently the girls have nowhere to sleep. They pretty much sleep on the floor, I guess. So, yep, so there's not really nothing else to say about, so about what to do here. So basically got the king's blessing. But it does open up a place where I need to go to. So I jump off. I'm not gonna call that as a baka jump. Because, well, it's a fast way to get out. I won't count that. Because it's not part of the plot. So, what I'm going to do now is I have to go to a place that just opened to us. Now I've done that stupid thing for the kink. So, I'm just going to look around here and proceed to the next part. So right now this is a new segmented video. So now since of course finished with that Troublemaker of a King, it opens up a new town. You know the problem with Athens, the way it was smashed up? Well, this time there's actually a new Athens that is available for us to go to. And it's probably one of the best places to go to. So you can see right now, since I'm so over-level in this particular part of the country, the enemies only give me 1 XP and 1 gold. So here we are in New Athens, and it's actually a quite big place here. And with that, there's actually new shops there available. Take your instance to this shop. So right now we're halfway through the game, and this is the only place that you can actually deposit items. I believe there may be another place later on, but it's not to the end of the game here. So if you're overflow, this is where you go to, and by then your inventory will probably be almost full. But just remember though that you cannot place key items in there. The game will not allow you to for some reason. So if you got keys there for a dungeon earlier, you still have to hold on to them for some godly reason again. Hence, Hercules. So I'm just going to store them for now, because I'm going to need some space later. Because, of course, new towns comes new equipment to buy. Let's see what this little shop has. So this is the place where you dig items. I'll be honest, I have no idea what they're used for. You basically use one of the buttons on your pad there, and you dig a hole, and you have an option to put the item in the hole. So maybe it's something like, it's like a bank? I'm not exactly sure there. It's not like you're planting anything. So this is actually a pretty good place here. All those nectars. The white nectar, of course, is good for HP. The blue nectar is good for MP. The gold nectar, I believe, is for your fainted. And the red nectar is good for stats ailments. Now, I should have mentioned this earlier about the way that the faint system is, and it's quite different. Because you're immortal, I'm pretty sure that's probably the reason, or maybe it's just a flaw in the program, but I don't think it is. When you, let's say you got 50 hit points left and you're fighting a battle, and let's say an enemy hits you. There's a good chance that you'll get zero, and basically your screen on the right turns white. You can still perform actions even your HP is still zero, but one more hit and you're pretty much done for. So basically, if that happens, either you gotta do a quick heal. You have to do a quick heal. Otherwise, you're gonna die next turn if he hits you with a spell or attack power. The next one is fainted. Fainted is basically your character in the right turn to red. And once you're fainted, you're pretty much dead. But actually, you can't die because you're immortal. But once all your characters are fainted, it's not technically game over. You just go back to this place where you save with Hermes. So there's no, if you notice them out in the games of Hercules, there's no, technically there's no churches. I think it's maybe one place, but so that's how death works, technically faint works. So this screen we're at right now is the armory, and these particular Athenes, I can't say Athenas, these are some of the best items in the game, and not only do they have good protection power, but they also give you good buffs to your intelligence and also your speed. And you notice this, the shield, the 30,000, that's probably one of the best shields in the game, buff-wise. You can probably equip these items and be pretty much be good for the rest of the game there, minus the weapons. So what I'm going to try to do is, I cannot equip the shield yet because I don't got enough money, but be sure later on, when I get more experience, I also get more money when I travel to different lands. Pretty much what I'm going to do is, I'm going to give everybody the helmet, the armor, and the cloak. Yeah, the cloak is one up than the hero's cloak I got with my party, so that's definitely high on my priority list. Of course, the armor, as mentioned before, gives you buffs. So not only, this is pretty much a pain in the butt it is. When you buy an item, it doesn't sell you the item you got equipped. It actually goes back to your inventory, and you have to go back to your inventory, use the sell option in the screen here to get rid of that item. And you pretty much need to save space. Plus, I need a little bit of cash anyway. I still got that stupid armor. Tuning fork, I got those from defeating enemies. I'm not sure which. It's pretty much useless. Definitely gonna save the laughing shield, because that's a free confusion against enemies. I believe you can find those laughing shields during the course of the game as well. I don't need this silver bow. And them to a holy jewel gem. I bought those holy jewel shops in case I get some cursed items, because some of the cursed items in the game are actually pretty good. Bad news is, once you unequip the item, of course, you know what happens, they come cursed once more. So it's not a permanent cure for the curse if you equip it. And for some reason, I still got the thorn whip, so yeah, I guess I'll just hold on to it in case I won't whip my companion to shape. So now I'm inside the weapon shop. Let's see. Now I finally got a sword here. And I got Dean's sword. However, there's going to be a very important weapon that's coming up. But another thing too, Rion still got that leaden rod, which now is pretty weak at this point. I think I have him for Axis as a specialist. Great Bow does have some attack power, but still is more of a mage than an attacker. Plus, I'll be losing the buffs from the Angel Bow at this point. So, I'm not going by the Great Bow. Great Bow has no, so this is a status screen here, just to show you here. I'm just checking a few things there. Yeah, I don't think I'll buy the Great Bow. Leave that alone. I'll need the intelligence and speed buff center at this point in time. So, as I mentioned in my early parts, one of the best weapons in the game, or swords for that matter, is called the Weaseling Sword. You get it for free, and it doesn't penalize your trust because it's found inside chests instead of finding inside, let's say, a cabinet or on the floor. The Weaseling Sword, I'll just mention again for you guys, is probably one of the most broken weapons in the game, and with good reason, and it does help considering the fact the way the fight system is, besides the silver rings and that. It doubles your strength power, and all it takes is just 1 MP. And that's going to, I believe, it's going to help against some of the enemies and bosses in the game greatly, especially when I have CPU controlled my characters. And you probably notice a lot of RPGs that if you allow the computer to control your characters, then they can help you greatly, especially if you're hit by, especially if they can heal you or revive you or do something that does a 180 and it works on the enemy, like putting them to sleep or pretty much confusing them. Oh, I should probably mention this as well. When I came to the New Athens, on the right-hand side, there was a palace there. And that actually leads to the gods. I believe that might be where next, but I'm just going to talk to a few people here. So there's actually a real problem in this place here because, well, just look at what you're saying there. So it seems that almost every town you go to, it seems that there's always something going on. And nothing's ever good. And let's the tempo there, I'll do that last. Now, I'm not sure you found the story right now, I'll just say it. Basically, what's happening right now is that, well, there's no sun. Something happened to the sun. It's always night. So this is a little temple. Yeah, so the sun stopped, so yeah. So now we got the heat, but there's no heat. The heat issue is gone, but now we got this. So if you're not following the story, I'm pretty sure you're not, because, well, and that treasure chest. Basically, they don't believe in gods anymore, and Zeus is mad, pissed off, and Hercules decides to help the people, but he lost his mighty strength. So that's why he's not as strong as he used to be in the other games. And look at that, they're using the sword, and we got it for free with no penalization on the trust on my comrades there. So now, this will probably be the last time I'm going to be using any spears. And I'll be using the reasoning sword. And this part of the game, I'm going to be doing a lot of damage, which I don't mind at all. So that's probably the main reason to come to this town. The upgrades, the bank, the dig, whatever that does, dig dirt, put items in, and get the sword. So if you're doing a fast track in this game, the reason sword probably will be the one item you definitely need to pick up. It's a major upgrade. And just to save space, I'm just going to sell some items because I'm not done with the money situation yet. I still have to get the Athena sword. Let's see, sword. The Athena shield, which is a big upgrade. And I don't need that because I do have my escape spell from Rion. Or XK, the game calls it. Now, as you know as well, if you buy the white or blue nectar, if pretty much fills up wherever it fills up. So, and it's extremely cheap. But I believe the blue nectar is probably more important than anything else. Because, well, for one thing, you can do major heals. And there's actually one better heal than the Paroetta, I think it's called. There's one that heals everybody. I think for 32 MP. So once I'm done with that, let's see what these people have to say. Now I actually was here earlier, but they didn't even say much. Yeah, there's nothing going on there. Am I supposed to come up here? Oh god, I can't remember now. Well, I'll have to come back here later. Alright, I actually made a mistake. I thought I was supposed to go to the gods yet, but I can't go there yet because I don't got anything to go to the gods yet. Or the heaven. I believe it's coming up later. I have to go to... There's actually another room that's opened up in this area. And I have to go to another mountain path. Because I believe the place I was at before, I needed a key to get there. I don't have that key yet. So that's where I need to go to. And these guys are just weak as hell. There's the quests. At this point, because my computer opponent, well, because I have computer opponents, if I get sleeping, rain will cure them. They do definitely like to heal those enemies there. You can see the damage is just unbelievable. 238. And the main character is not a caster type. But he does get some good attack spells later on, I recall. And what else? He does have some good healing spells, but one is nothing, since I did buy a lot of those blue nectars. So I'm not worried about MP at this point. Not unless the enemy uses M-Take like 50 times on me. Then I'll be worried. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna stop the video as soon as I head to the road pass there. And then we're going to walk around. I was thinking about maybe go around here to get some XP, but I don't think they give much XP much anymore anyway. I'll get a lot of it when I do the mountain pass. Okay, that's it there. Okay, I'm just gonna leave it go, and I'll see you next time, guys. We're in 74. See you next time. We'll see if we can get this game finished.